Good morning, everybody. How are you today? It is Friday. I am live in the stamping room, and I've had a 2-week break from my Facebook lives, and I have to tell you, 2 weeks is actually quite a long time, and I'm kind of a bit out of the swing of it. So let's see how this goes for us today. What have I been doing for the last 2 weeks? Well, I attended On Stage Local, which is a demonstrator event in Sydney, and that was awesome. So much fun. I got to hang out with my beautiful team, the six of us that went, which was pretty cool. So I'm from Adelaide, and a lot of my girls are from Adelaide, but I've got a lot of girls all over the country now as well. So going to a different state was actually pretty fun, because I got to meet some girls that I'd never met before in New South Wales, got to catch up with people that I don't see very often, and that's pretty fun. I love that. So we had a fabulous day at this one-day demonstrator event, and so much fun. So what do you do at an on-stage event? Well, we do lots of stamping. We hear about new products. We get a new catalogue, and I've got to show you. I can show you the front. Oh, gosh, you know what I've got in the front? Do you see this here? So that is my Office Works receipt, because yesterday I went and got my... Oh, good morning. Good morning, Kayla, with a beautiful name. And good morning, Julia. How are you this morning? It was lovely to meet you too, Kayla. You sweet thing. You are so gorgeous. So yesterday I went to Officeworks and I got my catalogue bound, and I got a plastic cover on the front, which I do every year. And this, one of the reasons why I do that is because I like to open my catalogue out super flat, like that, and also bend it backwards so it doesn't take so much room up on my desk. My catalogue gets a lot of work over this year, and I want it to last because I put lots of notes and things inside of it. And I also, one of the most important things with my catalogue is I put a little tick if I purchase something, and I highlight things, prices and so on, so I don't double up on things. And you'll be surprised, lots of my customers are now doing this as well. They highlight once they've purchased it, or they put a little tick by it, because it can be easy to forget that you've got something. I know that sounds crazy, but it happens. So anyway, this is the new Stampin' Up! Annual Catalogue, and we got this at On Stage. Now, it's a bit special to get this catalogue a bit early, and that's one of the perks of being a demonstrator and going to on-stage events. If you are one of my beautiful customers, then you will be, and you purchased from me within the last 12 months, I will be sending you your own annual catalogue for free. You get that for free if you are one of my regular customers and have purchased from me this past year. If you haven't, there is still plenty of time before I finalise my catalogues for this particular moment in time. And it's a great time to purchase things at the moment, because we have the retired list out. So, this poor catalogue, it's almost time to say goodbye to everything. And this one's been well loved. So lots of really fabulous products out of this catalogue and out of the Occasions catalogue, which has run away, are retiring, and they won't be in the new catalogue. So those things have been put on a retired list, and you can check that out by going to my blog, carolynbeating.com, and have a look at the retiring list. There's a lot of items that have also been reduced. Good morning, Katrina. How are you, sweet? So you can get a bargain while you're there. The other thing that you need to check out while you're there is the clearance rack. Holy smokes. What a surprise that was. Stampin' Up! Have updated their clearance rack. So some things on the clearance rack are up to 60% off. So now is a perfect time to stock up on all those really cheapy but fabulous products. That's the thing with the clearance rack. These aren't duds. These are great products that they just have a lot of inventory of. So make sure you go and check out the clearance rack. Now, if you spend $100 on retail products with me this month, so that's not postage and handling, that's retail products, I'm doing the most crazy sale. Good morning, Jeanette, how are you? I'm doing the most crazy sale I have ever done. Hang on, I've forgotten to update my laptop. I even put it on my lap so I wouldn't forget to do that, and I still forgot to update my laptop. There I am, I can see myself. I'm there. And I'm just going to share this as well. So that reminds me, I'm sharing this live video while it's live, and I would love it and appreciate it if you did that too, because that way the more people are watching, and I, you know, I get to speak to even more people and keep doing what I'm doing. Okay, so what was I talking about? Oh yes, my fabulous special this month. So the fabulous special that I've got this month, and I've never done it before, because I've got to tell you, I've told you this before, I am a little bit of a crazy hoarder when it comes to my Stampin products. And although I do sell off my retired products, I find it very hard to do that. And I've got three massive boxes of retired stamps, and that's not even including the ones that have just about to retire. And I could sell them. I prefer to give them away. So if you purchase $100 with me this month, from, I can't remember what the start date was of it. It wasn't from the beginning of the month, but I announced it further in. But if you're going to purchase $100 with me up until Sunday, you're going to get one of my pre-loved stamps as well. Now, these pre-loved stamps, they're not hacked stamps that I've, you know, they're covered in ink, they've been used to death. These are stamps that I might have only used perhaps one stamp out of the whole set, or they're brand new. Because being a demonstrator means that sometimes I don't get around to using all the stamps, and sometimes I perhaps might only use them once. So there's a lot of beautiful, very good quality stamps that are just sitting in a little box being unused and unloved, and I would really like to get them out to you guys, my customers. So if you do that, I will then add you to my list of people, and early next month I'll be popping those out. Good morning, Nicole. Free is good. I agree. Free is, how good is free? Free is the best. So, okay. That's, I think, all of the bits and bobs I need to talk to you about as far as what's happening. A little bit of an update on Possum Gate. So one of the reasons why I could not do my Facebook Live last week was we were in my hometown of Port Lincoln, which is about a 700 kilometre drive here from where I live in the Adelaide Hills. And both sides of our family still live in Port Lincoln, so we were visiting them over Easter. And when we came back, we got back Thursday afternoon, and I still had hopes and dreams of doing my Facebook Live on the Friday, except that when we walked into the house, lots of things were smashed and were laying about the place. Not like a robber, like stamp sets on the ground. And Archer, my seven-year-old's kindy pot plant, had been knocked over. You know, bizarre things that weren't quite right. So we, you know, just kind of settled ourselves in, unpacked, got ourselves sorted, and then I started to see a lot of poop everywhere, lots of poop. And then I came up to put away some of my stamping stuff that I'd taken with me, and here on my desk behind, there was a lot of poop and a lot of wee. And I freaked out. I thought we had rats, which is probably one of my all-time fears, rats inside. So the cleaning just got out of control. I went and did a lot of cleaning. There was a lot of disinfectant, there was a lot of vacuuming, there was a lot of stuff going down. And then we had dinner and we, Chris did some dishes and then I did some more cleaning because I was a bit crazy cleaning obsessed by this stage, getting more and more freaked out by the idea of having rodents. And there on top of our kitchen counter, hiding behind our mixmaster, was a possum. I've been sitting there for like 3 hours while I've been vacuuming past it and Chris has been doing dishes next to it and stuff. The poor thing must have been totally freaked out, but it had pooped and weed everywhere. So I just could not, don't worry, we got it outside nice and safely and it's returned to its husband. I think it must have been a girl possum because next day we found both of them hiding in the shed together and it was definitely the smaller one. But my poor desk has been very cleaned and I lost a few good things, but that's what happens. But today, so I'm back with you today. Possum craziness has all finished. We have plugged up the hole in the chimney that I think that the possum dropped down the chimney and like Father Christmas, and got a big surprise when it arrived and there wasn't very much good stuff in here to eat except for Archer's kindy pot plant, which was all gobbled up. So anyways, that's what's been happening for me. That's pretty crazy. But I'm going to get onto the stamping. So one of the fabulous things that Stampin' Up! Have released is a suite that's going to be in the new annual catalogue. I've lost the new annual catalogue. This suite thing. It's going to be in this. It's called the Eastern Palace Suite. And if you are a Pinterest fiend, you have probably been seeing this suite being popping up all around the place on Pinterest and all that kind of stuff. It is a really interesting suite. It's also, they've released three of the new in colours, which normally they keep under wraps, but they've released that to go with this new suite as well. Now, the new in colours that they've released are Tranquil Tide, Fresh Fig, and Lemon Lime Twist. And I'm still learning the names of these colours, but I want to tell you something pretty cool. Tranquil Tide will probably be a colour that I am just going to be very drawn to because I have issues with this colour. Look, my clothes are that colour. Here is the cardstock. I blend in. My bathroom tiles are that colour. Like, it's just, I'm insanely obsessed with this dark kind of teal colour. And so I think this one is going to be one of my absolute favourites. In fact, all of the ink colours this time are really, really awesome. It's funny, isn't it? I think they made this with me in mind. I think it should be called Carolyn's Colour. That could be the new version. So if you're desperate for a new purple in your life, Fresh Fig is going to really rock your socks. And if you like something nice and zesty, then the Lemon Lime Twist is also going to be pretty darn awesome for you. I think the other two colours, a very light pink colour and a very juicy berry colour, are going to be probably my go two colours as well, because you know I like pink, that's me. But some of these, I actually like all of the in colours this season, which is not always the case. I've been a little bit late to the party with this one. I know I've told people before that one didn't do it for me, but now I've seen it on stuff and now I like it, you know, I'm easily converted. But the Eastern Palace Suite, you're going to love. It's available to purchase. For demonstrators, you can get that now. So if you are currently a demonstrator, you love the Lemon Lime Twist, Kayla. Yeah, I know. Everyone's different, which is great. You love the Lemon Lime Twist. All right, well, you see, you would use, Port Power colours, Denise. Isn't that funny? I never thought, do you know what? I think it's not quite Port Power colours, but definitely I'm a port. You know, if I'm going to fall under any football team, it's Port Power, that's my family's team, so that could be fun. But so the Eastern Palace suite, you've got a couple of different ways of going about getting your hands on the suite. If you're a demonstrator, then you can purchase it right now as a pre-order, which is pretty darn cool. Another perk for being a demonstrator. And if you want to come and join my team, come on. It's where it's all happening, people. And you can get 20% discount as well, which is awesome. The other, but if you are a customer, then you can purchase it as of the 1st of May, which is just next week. There are two bundles that Stampin' Up! Are releasing. One is the starter bundle, and it's got lots of pretty cool stuff in it. I'll read it out. It's got like the stamp set, which is here. I've got my phone facing the opposite way today. So that's the stamp set. At first, the stamp set didn't rock my socks, but now it's really growing on me. I really like the sentiments and the way it works with the framelits. That's really what makes this bundle work amazingly. So you've got the stamp set, you've got the designer series paper, and as I said, you've got those three new ink colours with that. You've got these beautiful gold vinyl stickers, which I don't have to show for you today. You've got the Lemon Lime ink pad, the Tranquil Tide ink pad, and the Fresh Fig ink pad. And as a free extra perk, you've got some Very Vanilla note cards and envelopes being thrown in for free. So those don't actually cost you anything. That's awesome. And that is $104.75. So if you're looking to join as a demonstrator, you could actually use this Eastern Palace starter bundle as in your starter kit, which is pretty cool. And then you'd have a few extra bits and bobs to add to that starter kit as well. The Eastern Palace Premier Bundle is a little bit more, but you get more stuff. So it's $178.25 here in Australia. And you get the thinlets as well with that. And some tassels. The tassels are really very cute. And the designer series paper that coordinates with it. You get, and instead of the note cards and envelopes as your freebie, you get a pack of 40 Very Vanilla C6 envelopes and the Very Vanilla thick A4 cardstock. And I think the thick A4 cardstock is brand new. We've had the Whisper White for the last year and it's become one of my personal favourites because I do a lot of white cards. So those two bundles are going to be available as of Monday to purchase. And if you're a demonstrator or if you're looking to join up, you can do that. You can use those straight away now. So what have I been making with this bundle? Well, it's been school holidays, so I haven't been making a ton of stuff. I'm sorry to say. Those three little munchkins of mine do swallow up a lot of time, but I love them, so we'll keep them. But I have been making a few things. I've shared a couple of things on my Facebook page here and also on my blog over at carolynbenny.com. This is one that I made, and I think I'm not very good at getting things on shot at today. I think one of the really amazing things about these framelits, and I'll show you them in a minute, is they partially cut the cardstock. So it's not cut there, but it's cut there. So you can get things kind of coming up and getting raised out of the cardstock there. It's something that I've never seen before. Not just Stampin' Up! World, but in other companies as well. I mean, I'm sure there might be something out there, but I just haven't seen something like that before. Now, with this card, I've run through the framelits multiple times to get that effect and put some white cardstock behind it. And this is a new punch that's coming as well. It's so cool. I love that punch. And that's a beautiful, one of the beautiful sentiments in the set, which I think is really sweet. So that's one of the cards that I've been making. The other card that we're going to make today is this one here. What do you think of that? Now this is using Fresh Fig. Now, I've got to tell you, this colour is quite a dark colour for me. And I tend to be more of a white, crumb cake, light pink kind of girl. So one of the things I tend to fall back on, if a colour is a little dark for me, and I'm not quite sure if I'm happy with that colour just by itself, is I use a little bit of white craft ink over the top of it just to make it a little bit subtle and to kind of mute it a little bit. So I want to show you how I've done that. I also want to show you how I've coloured this little framelit here and made these beautiful circles here as well out of the framelits, which are really fun. So this is kind of more my style, I suppose, than some of the very Eastern influences in that are shown in and some of the really bright, I wonder if you can see. So that's what Stampin' Up! Have given us as far as some options. Now, that's probably not my style, the very bold colours and the very, it's just very bold, okay? I'm not very bold. I'm more of a subtle girl. And I think it's really important to remember whenever you see a framelit set or if you see something in the catalogue and the colours don't sing to you or the style doesn't sing to you, you're not stuck with that. You can do whatever you want. So just impose your style onto that set and you'll be surprised that you can really make some fabulous things happen if you put your style into your projects and not just go, oh, well, it says Eastern, so we must have to do like an Eastern theme. No, you can do whatever you want. This is your creative world, people. So let's get crafting. I've got a bit to get through. I'm hoping that I can replicate this nicely for you guys live. But you know what? Anything goes when it's live. So let's see what's going to happen. I'm going to flip you guys. I don't know. You get to see my lovely... my lovely light fitting. Why is that like so? Maybe I need to scoot you across a little bit. There we go. Okay. Can you see? Is that all working for everybody? Give me a little bit of comment just to make sure. Okay, I think we're good. All right. Is that close enough? I hope so. Okay. So please tell me in the comments if anything doesn't look right. And I think I flipped it today. So is that reading correctly? Can you see? Is it actually working? Can we see it the right way? Or is it not right now that I've done it that way? Yeah, it's backwards again. Oh, well, I'm sorry. It's backwards. I thought I'd worked out the magic potion of it not being backwards, but oh well. Okay. So Eastern Beauty is the stamp set. These images are shown, they're shown at 70%, so they're smaller on the front. Don't freak out, not that small. On the inside, there you get like a beautiful little pack of photopolymer stamps, and they're all nested in there together, which is lovely. I also want to show you the framelits. So you get lots of framelits. In fact, you get 14. I like a lot when you get lots. And I've taken them all out of the little sticky sheet that we get given. Little sticky sheet does my head in. I need to get some magnetic sheets. Now, if anyone's got a great supplier of magnetic sheets, I want strong ones. I don't want light ones. If anyone's got a magnetic sheet supplier, please PM me or message me, because backward text, really sorry, guys. I don't know. How can I fix that? I don't think I can. Let me see. Oh, hang on. Did I fix it? I think I might have. All right. I'm rocking it today, people. Okay. All right. So, okay. I'm pretty excited. I'm a bit pleased with myself with that. I fixed it. Okay. So, now I can see what you guys are seeing, which is fabulous. So, these are all of the framelits. Now,
these, they nest inside of each other, which is what makes this stamp set really pretty cool. So let me see, this one nests inside that one. And we've got this one that nests inside that one. And then you can do all sorts of things. You can have that happening, you can have that happening, and then you can mix them all about. These ones also, you've got three different ones there, and I've just stuck them in one place with a piece of washi tape over the top because I want to roll this through the Big Shot and I want them all to be nested inside each other. You can swap them out so you can have the different little inserts if you want to make yours look different. You can, and they're all slightly different patterns, so you can change that up. The thing that you will find is this one and this one cut out the images completely. So you get images that completely cut out with that one and with that one. But all of the rest, oh no, hang on. I think that one, some of the little ones also cut completely out. But these ones here, they don't, the cutting bit isn't all the way around. So they only partially cut out the images, which is how these ones here are only part, they're not completely popped out. I haven't just stuck them in. That's because they've only partially cut out. So you'll get some beautiful raised bits and some bits that are completely stuck still on there. So that's, it's great because there's lots of different ideas that you can play around with and things that will happen once you get that sorted in your mind. So, okay, so let's get rid of some of these I'm not using. I'll pop them back in that little plastic. I'm good at making a mess and not so good at tidying up as I go. So, tidying up as you go is pretty boring. Crafting is the exciting bit. Yeah, the washi tape is, you know, and it's probably naughty because I probably could find a more cost-effective way of and not just using my new washi tape, but it's close at hand, which I like. Now, Kayla said I purchased thick ones from eBay. Yes, and that's what I need, thick sheets of magnetics to stick my framelits on. I wish that Stampin' Up! Would do that for us. Well, I might sandbox them about that. Okay, so what I want to do is, put my card over here so I can. Now I'm going to bring Bertha Big Shot in. Have I told you guys before that I name my Big Shot? So you have to. So one of my rules are that you have to name your Big Shot when you purchase a Big Shot from me, because you know you name your sweet cars, don't you? That you love your cars that mean something important to you. So why wouldn't you name your amazing Big Shot? I mean, seriously, this is going to be one of your most loved things in the whole world. So mine's called Bertha. She has a little pink ribbon. I also thought Bertha was going to die on me not so long ago. So I bought Bert, and Bert has a blue ribbon. But Bert has to live in the cupboard because, strangely, Bertha made a complete recovery after I bought Bert. And she obviously didn't want to be replaced. So here is the framelits. They're all nested together. I've got a little bit of washi over them. I've popped them on my precision cutting plate because I love the precision cutting plate. I've got Bertha around the wrong way, but oh well, I'll do. Be all right. It doesn't work if I don't stand up there. Come on, Bertha. Okay. Oh, I forgot to do something. I'm going to show you this again. The other thing I wanted to show you is that the layering circle framelits actually work perfectly with the Eastern Palace framelits. So these framelits we've already had in the catalogue, and we're going to keep them in the catalogue, which is good to know. And they actually work really beautifully with this set. So you can roll that through at the same time. I didn't do that, but you can. You just stick a little bit of washi on it and roll it through again. See if I can get this happening without the crazy wobbling happening. Okay. So here is now we've got that cut out. Now I'm going to get my dye brush and do a little bit of brushing. This just gets the, see all the little bits that are coming out. You said, yes, you told them as well, I agree. We've got to do that, don't we? Okay, check this out. Isn't that super beautiful? Now, I could just probably get a few more of those bits out. We can get your paper piercer, which I've now lost. Holy smokes. And get all those last little bits out. Where's my paper? Yes. So you could keep using the brush, but I do generally just pop out the last few bits with a paper piercer. Check that out. What do you think? How lovely. Now, if I hadn't have put this around the outside, it would be stuck in the white paper. It wouldn't have come all the way out. But I want to have two of those. So I've gone ahead already and cut another one out, so I've got two exactly the same. But they're really pretty. I kind of think they're kind of a bit of a lace effect on those, even kind of a doily effect, which is very nice because you can do them whatever color you please. The other, hello Leonie. Hello Carolyn, oh my gosh. So here, now we want to make some of these. And I'm gonna bring you in a little bit closer for the coloring, because I always think you wanna see nice and close. So I'm going to pop that there so I know where I need to be. So with the coloring, I always go back to shimmery white. It is probably one of my, it's my favourite colouring paper these days. I'm always going back to shimmery white. And I'm using here some basic black in the archival ink. And this is one of the fabulous stamps out of Eastern Beauty. Yeah. Nice. Well, I've done better. Anyways. And then we're going to get some of the fresh big. Now, you guys know I love to colour. So I always look at a set and try and work out how am I going to colour with this set. I love shimmery white too, Leonie. Oh my goodness. Okay, so here. Now, the thing I worked out with fresh big pretty quickly was it's really dark. And it does not... It does not lose its colour if you are colouring with it. If I just put this on here, it would be dark from the beginning bit to the end. It's a really strong pigment. So you kind of just have to be a bit careful how much ink you start with. So with this one, I just decided to actually be a bit random. Try and get, those two things are probably not words you will hear together very often, Carolyn and random, because I like all of my ducks in a row. So being random is a challenge for me, but I just wanted this to have a bit of a kind of a natural feel about it, like it's a flower, I suppose. So I'm just going out and leaving some white. Now I probably come in with a little bit more colour, make it darker at the end, at the centre. So at the moment, Chris, who's my husband, he's an assistant principal at a primary school. So he's on holidays as well, and he has taken my boys out for a little bit of time to give me time to do my Facebook Live. It's nice and quiet. Otherwise, you would be hearing three crazy boys running around the house, which is fine, except I wouldn't be able to concentrate. So thank you, Chris, for doing that for me. But I wanted to share something that Chris said to me the other day, and perhaps you guys are the only people on the planet that would recognize how crazy this statement was. So Chris said to me, he came in and he was doing our house is a very old cottage, and he wanted to strip some paint off of the door that's in my craft room here. Fabulous, happy about that. That door's looked horrible for years. And he said, do you think that I could borrow your heat gun so I could strip paint? No, you cannot borrow my heat gun so you can strip paint. Is it crazy? Okay. But anyways, I thought that was pretty funny. So he went down to the hardware store and bought a heat gun. So now this is one of the little tiny stamps from the set, which I didn't think much of when I first saw it, but it is so pretty when you use it with this, well, I think it's a flower, but it could be something else. It could be just a pattern, but I think it looks just, it makes this really rock. Can you guys see that, yeah? How beautiful is that? And I think with me trying to be random with the colouring, it kind of works. Oh, that was a little too random. Oh well, sometimes that happens. And then we're just going to cut that out with our Big Shot. So what would happen with that is you just pop that around it. If you have a magnetic platform, you can use that too. But I kind of like to use washi tape and just roll that through like so. But here, with the magic of television, I've got one prepared already. So we're going to use that one. The other thing that you're going to do is get your piece of Tranquil Tide, maybe the very, probably the best colour Stampin' Up has ever made, and we're going to pop that through with this piece, because I thought it kind of needed like a little bit of a leafy feel underneath of it, and so we're going to get one of those, okay? Once you've done that, we're going to do a little bit of stamping on this one here. So where are you watching from today? Tell me in the comments. I'd love to know where you're watching from. I always love, that's kind of one of those really cool things. My dad was into ham radio. It was always like just so cool when people from around the world would say where they were calling from. Does anyone know what ham radio is? Now this is another little stamp that I thought at first, well, what do you use that for? But how pretty is it when it gives you those little effect of it being really dark at the ends and then spotting in. Check that out. Isn't that beautiful? I can think of lots of ways I can use that. Okay, so we've got these two, the effect is like so, and I'm going to put a dimensional behind that. Oh, this is a pre-loved piece of cardstock. Sometimes I make blunders and I just flip over the cardstock and use the back of it, because our cardstock, especially the shimmery white, is so thick you can do that. Yes, I make lots of blunders. Doesn't everybody? Henley Beach. Oh, I'm sorry, Leanne. I know, Balhanna is a little bit away up the hill, but it's worth it. And lots of my ladies come up and they go out for lunch afterwards and they go shopping at the fabulous Balhanna by Design. They make a day of it. You should definitely do that. For sure. So here is a piece of fresh fig. Now this one here is cut. You're from New South Wales, of course, Sherry. Of course. Oh, now Tarragon. Oh, please, just seem to help me. That one's tricky. I don't know how to say that one. I'm going to have to practice. Oh, from your work just with a coffee. Leonie, you know I want a coffee. you don't message me and talk about coffee, Leonie Schroeder. That is outrageous. I'm hanging out till I finish. So this piece here I've cut just a few, probably about 5 mils shorter. And so this one here was 10.5 centimetres. And this one here is about 10 centimetres across. The width here is 14.9 centimetres, which is about half of the width of, this is a piece of A4 cardstock. We had two, had the piece of A4. I cut it right down in the middle at 10.5. And then I'm going to, oh gosh, now I've got some of these measurements wrong. I'll put the right measurements in the blurb. So this one is actually about 10 centimetres, and this one must be about 9.5 centimetres. This is what happens when you do things late at night. Anyways, so I've got the smaller one. That's really the main thing. And I've got my craft white ink pad. And like I said to you before, sometimes I just like to mute the colours a little bit. So, and this is how I do it. Oh, it's a bit too close now, isn't it? Sorry, my loves. I'm really getting a bit close. Victor Harbour. Yes. Hey, Jeanette, how are you? I'm so glad that you came up. I hope everything's going well for you now. Okay, so that's how I like to do it. I like a little bit random. I like that soft. If you wanted to do it a little bit less random with those lines, you could do that too. You just have to be a little bit more beautiful Barossa. Well, that's Laura and the beautiful Barossa. Now, so isn't that really cool? So that effect is just with plain white ink mushed over the top, and that's at full strength. So that's a big difference, isn't it? It just makes it a really subtle effect when you have those together. It takes that color down a little bit, which I like. I like that soft feel. I mean, I'm going to use this color for lots of different things, but I really like that soft feel. And here we've got our two, should we call them doilies? Is that okay if we call them doilies? So I'm going to do that, and here I'm going to use my poor old washi tape. Again, we're going to get poor old washi tape. It's a used and abused. It's a very necessary requirement in my craft room. So we're going to be covering this up. I've just kind of made them match. The patterns match either side. I'm using my washi tape. We're going to be... So it's okay. It's okay. If you're using your craft stuff, it's okay however you use them. So I've got that like so. And I'm going to bend that over. How am I going for time, girls? Because the Facebook Live will just cut out if I'm going for too long. I did turn on my timer. So I better, if it cuts out, I'll just restart it again in another video, which is bad because I've waffled for too long. I apologize. So I'll see if I can speed it up a little bit. Now I'm going to stick this on the back. You could use just regular tape, but again, I'm lazy and I use washi. Okay, how's that? Now we're going to pop that on. And I've used a little bit of my white baker's twine because I love that really. I don't know, it's kind of a, you could use this as a wedding card, but you could also use this as a Mother's Day card. Wouldn't that be beautiful to give to your mum? I might do that. Shh, don't tell mum. I don't know that she watches my Facebook Live. Do you watch, mum? You might have to comment if you do. I know that she often is out walking with her friends at this time of the day. And I do I speak to my dad. My dad's a real techno dude. And I talk to my dad on Fridays normally because mum's out and about. So here I've got a little bit of white baker's twine. I've wrapped it around twice. And I'm just going to bring in those little ears of my bow. Like so. And I will give them a chopper. Okay. I think I could fiddle with that bow a little bit more to make it a bit prettier. But we're short on time, so I'm going to leave it like so. Then after that, I want some double-sided tape. So did you see that I'm facing a different way today, girls? I don't know why I started facing the other way when I did my Facebook Lives. I mean, of course you can't see a damn thing at the moment because you're looking at my hands. But I don't know why I started facing the other way. You know how you start doing stuff and you don't know why? So I thought I would go this way today. I'm worried that when winter comes, I'm going to lose all of my light because here in the hills, it gets a bit cold and dark. Okay, which way is up? I think that way. Looks good. I'll pop that in there. Okay. It's coming together. Did I make this the right size? Yes, I did. Now, why am I wasting all this cardstock, Carolyn, when you can hardly see it? Why am I layering? All right, so this is the thing. I layer because these subtle little lines either side, so the dark cardstock showing behind just lifts your project. It really does. You need to consider just using a little bit more cardstock so you can just have a little bit of a layering behind it. I love Tombow glue because it gives you a couple of minutes to shimmy it if it's not centered. Okay, you see how those lines just make just a little beautiful sound effect. Now you see how on this one here, the sentiment is curved. It's awesome. It actually comes curved. I'm not going to use this one because I'm going to use it for my Mother's Day card. And that one isn't quite right, that sentiment for that particular instance. But here I've used it. It says life is beautiful. And the fact that it rocks around this curve is just stunning. But the good thing is as well, because it's photopolymer, you have it flat too. You can actually make it straight, which is pretty cool. I fiddled around with that last night and it worked. So, but I think I threw that. That was something else went wrong with that one. But so you can do actually a curve around there, or I'm going to probably find something and do a straight one down there. I often find that it's my sentiments that trip me up. How do you guys feel about that? Hey Lorraine, how are you? I find it's often my sentiments. I'm fine with the rest of the card. And then I get to the end and go, where am I going to put my sentiment? I've thought about that last. So I'm making a really conscious effort to plan out where my sentiments go first and then plan the rest of my card. Is anyone else like that? Are you bad with sentiment placement or is it just me? Holy smokes, I'm not good at that. I often think if I'd be better off not having sentiments at all. So with this card, I have not got the white layering on the outside. That this one's just a full width across, and this one's got a white piece either side. And I think I like the white either side just a little bit better. So there you'll be able to see the difference. This one's a little bit smaller and this one's a little bit bigger, and you can't see the white cardstock either side. But you know, both are pretty cute. What do you think? Do you like this project? Do you like the Eastern Palace bundle? Can you see some different uses for it than what you had seen before? All right, let's flip up. Here I am. I'm back. You have trouble with sentiments too. Yes. I can't find this. Look, so do you know what? This could be a great Facebook Live topic that we could talk about.
where to put sentiments on cards and some ideas and tips, because I've actually been doing some research on this. I'm taking it that seriously. Why is sentiment placement so darn hard? Okay, that'll be another Facebook Live that we can talk about. But that's it today, guys. I'm so pleased that you've come and joined me on my Facebook Live. It was actually really fun making that card together. I hope you liked it. I will be sharing that on my blog today, which I will type up a blog post in a minute while I've got some free time, child-free time. Make the use of it and put all the details of the promotion there of the Eastern Palace bundle too. You like the white too? Mm-hmm. Yeah, me too. So I hope you have a fabulous weekend. If you're here in SA and you've got kidlets, this is the last few days of the school holidays. All back to systems normal next week for me. I've got a class up here in the Adelaide Hills, my monthly class. And then it's going to be fun getting back into the work swing and getting back into the swing. I'll miss the kidlets and my husband back at work, but, you know, that's the way it goes, isn't it? We're lucky to have so many holidays together. But have a fabulous week. And until I see you again, stay safe and keep making cards, people. All right. Bye.